I quit my full-time job to become a YouTuber. Now, that is by far the biggest risk I've ever taken, and I have no plan B. So why? You know how the usual story goes, right? Little Johnny hates his 9-to-5 job. He has a tyrant boss, Bob, that looks over his shoulder every time he takes a bathroom break. He makes a bad pay and wastes his days doing work that has no meaning. Working jobs that we hate so we can buy shit we don't need. We heard the story of Johnny 1,000 times before, but it's not my story. You see, I had a job that I liked, working with people that I loved, in a media company that did do meaningful work. So what's wrong with me?
What's wrong with you people?
I could already see how the next 20 years would play out. I would keep doing honest, decent work, get decent paychecks, buy a decent house, raise decent kids, retire at a decent age, and most of all, do all those things feeling incredibly comfortable. So why did I quit? Well, I heard Steven Spielberg say something a while back. He said,
"Sometimes a dream almost whispers, so you have to every day of your lives be ready to hear what whispers in your ear, it very rarely shouts."
And I had those whispers in my ear telling me I had more to give to the world and more to expect from myself. I'm 29 now, and my life is nowhere near where I thought it'd be at that point. When we're kids, we picture ourselves becoming all of those great things that we dream of. And I've realized that I grew up to become none of those things. I'm a failed football player, I'm a failed musician, but ironically, I've always been a very good employee, a very good student. I've always excelled at helping others achieve their dreams, abiding by a system that pushed me into sabotaging myself in the process. And soon those whispers in my ears starting to sound more like questions. Am I gonna grow old and bitter because I settled on realistic choices? Am I gonna die regretting not taking more risks? How will I one day be able to tell my future kids to follow their dreams if I never did? So I decided to do what I thought was unthinkable. I left my job to build a life that my 6-year-old self dreamed of, doing the things that my 6-year-old self dreamed of. I'm starting from 0 subscribers, and I'm either gonna grow and get to that vision that I set for myself, or crash and burn for you all to witness. Either way, it's probably gonna be entertaining. But in order for you guys to be the judge of that, I thought you need an accurate depiction of where my life is at today, so you can see if I either progress or start selling my stuff. So I thought I'd give you a house tour. But before we do that, a word from our sponsor.
Hi!
My girlfriend, Charlotte.
Fiance.
I wanted to take the time to introduce her because as much as some people drive motivation from their haters, telling them they can't do something, I drive my motivation from people believing in me, and that is Charlotte. I am very blessed to have such an amazing partner and a supportive family. We were supposed to get married last summer. No.
This summer.
Yes. We were supposed to get married this summer, but the pandemic happened, so we pushed it to next summer, and I just quit my job.
Yep.
So we'll see what happens. I guess it depends on you guys.
No pressure. Okay, so now it's house tour time. Through my ears and it's lifeless a rule to the game. Number one, be yourself. Number two, never change. Number three, keep it cheap while you go through your thing. Number four, stay raw, get used to the game. Have people try to clap on my style type. What you see is what you get, don't believe in facades. Love who I am, believe me, I'm proud. I'm who I am and I'm screaming it loud. Think I give a damn if you don't like all the things I do. All I care about is the vibes I bring to you. I just set it out with the hopes that it cling to you. My name like your phone, I can bet that it ring to you. Proud of me, confident that if I ain't the best, I'm about to be. No matter who doubted me, ain't no cloud in me. I'ma prove you wrong, and that proof you gone. Like, and you got to check out my ride. Yo, through my years, and it's lifeless and rules to the game. Number 5, stay loud. Number 6, be the same. Gotta stay true to you, probably be at number 7. Number 8, use your mind as a weapon, protect yourself. Number 9, homie, check yourself. Number 10, easy, that's homie, get your weapon. There you go. This is it. This is the starting point. And I'm inviting you guys to be part of that journey. Now, in the next few months, I'll be releasing documentary-style content on subjects that I'm passionate about. I want my content to entertain, educate, but mostly challenge the perceptions that we have of things. We live in an era where the media landscape is so polarizing that I realize that one of the truest acts of courage is learning to think for yourself. And that's the kind of content I want to make. YouTube.
a new player entered the game. And by the way, my name is...
Before we cut any beginning comments, before we start doing this...
You're one of the greats. And you heard it here.
You heard it here first.
You heard it here first.
Yeah, one of the greats.
Yep.
Thank you.
That's all.